sixth property is the sum of n odd numbers, the sum of first n, the sum of first n odd numbers is n square. Now the example is, suppose I am writing one odd number, first odd number is your 10, first odd number is your 10 and its sum is 1 square. I have written two odd numbers, sum of these odd numbers is 4 and it can be written as 2 square. Sum of first three odd number, 1 plus 3 plus 5 is 3 is 9, that can be written as 3 square. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 is 16, that is 4 square. Got it? The sum of first n odd numbers is always n square. If I write 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So answer must be 8 square, that is 64. If you will count the sum of these terms, they will be surely, the sum of these terms is surely 64. Got it? So this is your property number 6. Yes, listen, one more thing I want to clear it. यहाँ पे देखो, आपने देखा वन स्क्वायर इट कैन बी रिटन एज सम ऑफ वन ऑड नंबर, टू स्क्वायर इट कैन बी रिटन एज सम ऑफ टू ऑड नंबर, थ्री स्क्वायर कैन बी रिटन एज सम ऑफ थ्री ऑड नंबर. बट इफ अ नेचुरल नंबर कैन नॉट बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज अ सम ऑफ कंसेक्टिव ऑड नंबर, दैट मींस दैट नंबर इज नॉट अ परफेक्ट स्क्वायर. अब यहाँ देखो, इसके बीच में दिस इज योर टू स्क्वायर फोर, बट एंड दिस इज योर थ्री स्क्वायर दैट इज नाइन. But in between 4 and 9, we have so many terms. We have 5, 6, 7, 8. That means 5 number cannot be written as sum of odd numbers. Ye 5, 4 ho gaya. Yahan pe aap ek aur 1 likhoge. So 1 and 1 is repeating. Like I have written 6. So 1 plus 3 plus 5, agar aap lete ho, toh these numbers when added, they will not give you 6. Means in between these two numbers, so many numbers are occurring, but it's not possible every time that each number will be written as a sum of consecutive odd number. So if a natural number cannot be written as a sum of odd number, that means that number is not a perfect square number. As we all know, 5 is not a perfect square number, 6 is not a perfect square number, 7, 8, they are all not a perfect square number because they cannot be written as a sum of odd consecutive numbers. Property is property number 7. The square of any odd number, write down, the square of any odd number. Next is, the square of any odd number can be expressed, the square of any odd number can be expressed as a sum of two consecutive positive integer, can be expressed as a sum of two consecutive odd consecutive positive integers. Got it? So the next property is, you can express any odd number square as a sum of two consecutive positive integers. Like I'm giving you one example here. Any odd number. Odd number. So if you write one square, you cannot write it as except one. This property is for except one, means you will not start from one, you will start from the next odd number. दैट इज थ्री. सो थ्री स्क्वेयर इज नाइन, विच कैन बी रिटन एज फोर प्लस फाइव, विच कैन बी रिटन एज फोर प्लस फाइव. नेक्स्ट इज योर फाइव स्क्वेयर विच इज सिक्सटीन, सॉरी विच इज ट्वेंटी फाइव, विच कैन बी रिटन एज, हाउ यू विल राइट दिस एज, ट्वेल्व प्लस थर्टीन. नेक्स्ट इज योर सेवन स्क्वेयर दैट इज फोर्टी नाइन, विच कैन बी रिटन एज ट्वेंटी फोर प्लस ट्वेंटी फाइव. But so these are the small numbers, so I have written them directly. But if the number is large, like 107 square, 109 square, so it's not possible for you to write them, to break it up into two consecutive positive integers. So we have a method that is given by you. This number 3 square is your n square. So the formula for this is n square can be written as n square minus 1 by 2 and n square plus 1 by 2. So the square of any number, any odd number, can be written as n square minus 1 by 2, n square plus 1 by 2. I can give you so many examples related to this. Wait. This is the general formula. Like, now let's verify this formula for all of these numbers. Like I have written 5 square. So when you write here 5 square minus 1 by 2 and 5 square plus 1 by 2, so 5 square is 25, 25 minus 1 is 24 by 2, that is your 12. This is 25 plus 1, 26 by 2, on dividing this will give you 13. So the numbers are 12 and 13. Is it clear? Is it clear, beta? Any doubt? So this is the formula to find that any odd number can be written as a sum of consecutive positive integers. I'm going to verify this formula again for the different examples. Look here, like I'm taking one another example, like 9 square. 9 square you all know is 81. Now let's break up this 9 square into the sum of two consecutive positive integers. So this 9 square can be written as 9 square minus 1 by 2, 9 square plus 1 by 2. Look here, 9, 81 minus 1 by 2, 81 plus 1 by 2, that will give you 80 by 2, that is 40, and this one is 82 by 2, that is 42. So when you add them, you will surely get, this is 41. When you add them, you will surely get 81 as answer. So that means any square of any odd number can be written as sum of consecutive positive integers. They are positive integers. They are also positive integers. Like if you want to verify this for the bigger number also, you can verify. Like I can write one more example, 105 square. So you can find it like, take some small example like 27 square, which is 27 square minus 1 by 2, 27 square plus 1 by 2. So from here, you will get two numbers which can be written as a sum of 27 square. Bache, in the try, the second first question is related to the property that the square of the even number is always even and the square of the odd number is always odd. Now let's start with the question number 2 of the same triadi, in which first part is your 60. So what will be the number of zeros in the square of this? If you make the square of this number, how many zeros the answer of this number will contain? As you can see that it is having one zero. If you make the double of this, like 60 into 60, it will surely give two zeros. Is it so, beta? Is this clear? And the next part is 400. If you make the square of this, here I'm having two zeros. When you make the square of 400 will contain four zeros. Is this clear? Two zeros are there. If you make the square of this, it will surely give you four zeros. Got it? Let's start the try these related to the page number पेज नंबर 94, ट्राई दिस नंबर वन. यस, यू विल टेल मी विच प्रॉपर्टी वी विल यूज हियर. हाउ मेनी नेचुरल नंबर लाई बिटवीन 9 स्क्वेयर एंड 10 स्क्वेयर. हाउ मेनी नेचुरल नंबर लाई बिटवीन 9 स्क्वेयर एंड 10 स्क्वेयर. यस, हु विल टेल मी द रिलेटेड प्रॉपर्टी. You must remember about the property that in between n square and n plus 1 square, this is your 9 and this is your 9 plus 1 gives you 10. Is it so? Is this clear? This is your 9 square and this is your 10 square. They are consecutive number. So that is related to n square and n plus 1 square. So in between n square and n plus 1 square, there are 2n non-perfect square number between them. तो नॉन परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर मींस ऑल नंबर्स, चाहे वो स्क्वेयर हैं या नहीं है, दे इंक्लूड ऑल द नंबर्स. तो अगर नॉन परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर की जगह नेचुरल नंबर आ जाए, दैट विल बी एग्जैक्टली सेम. सो इन बिटवीन दीज टू, हाउ मेनी नंबर्स वी वांट टू फाइंड, दैट हाउ मेनी नंबर्स आर लाइंग हियर. सो इन बिटवीन दीज टू देयर आर 2n नेचुरल नंबर्स बिटवीन n square and n plus 1 whole square. Is this clear? This is your property. There are 2n natural number between n square and n plus 1 square. So n is your 9 here and n plus 1 is 10. So there are 2n number, n is your 9. So that means between these two, there are 18 natural numbers. 18 natural numbers are lying between 9 square and 10 square. 18 natural numbers are lying between 9 square and 10 square. Is this clear? Yes, give me the answer of this question, Shabad. Hurry up.
Mom, yes. Good morning.
How many numbers, natural numbers are lying between 11 square and 12 square?
Ma'am, we will, there are 2n natural, ma'am, we will follow this method which is followed in A part. 2n, 2 into 11.
Natural numbers between 11 square and 12 square. Got it? So this is the B part of the same question. Page number 94, try these number 2. So many numbers are written here. You have to decide which one is a perfect square and which one is not. First is 12, then 55, 81, 49, and 69. So you have to decide whether they are perfect square or not. Like in the first property, you have written that if a number is ending with 2, 3, 7, or 8, it will surely be not be a perfect square number. But if the numbers are ending with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, and 9, they may or may not be a perfect square number. Got it? So here it is ending with 2. So it is not 12 is ending with 2. So it is not a perfect square number. Got it? So it is not a perfect square number. Next number is 55. It is ending with 5. So will it be a perfect square or not? Who will tell me? Is this a perfect square number? Is this a perfect square number, beta? Hurry up. So according to the same property, if it is ending with 5, it may or may not be a perfect square number. So 55 is not a perfect स्क्वेयर नंबर। बेटा इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज व्हाट डू मीन बाय परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर, मींस अगर आप 2 का स्क्वेयर करते हो 4 मिलता है, सो 4 इज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर। 7 का स्क्वेयर करते हो 49 यू आर गेटिंग, 49 इज अ परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर। इफ यू मेक 8 स्क्वेयर दैट इज 64 व्हिच इज अगेन अ परफेक्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर। सो इन बिटवीन 4 स्क्वेयर लाइक 16 एंड 5 स्क्वेयर लाइक 25, सो मेनी नंबर्स आर लाइंग बिटवीन देम। Between these two numbers, there are 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. These numbers are lying. They are all not perfect square. So similar is the case like between 7 square, that is 49, and 8 square is 64. 55 is lying between them, which is not a perfect square number. Because this number 55, you are not getting on making the square of any number. If you make the square of any natural number, 55, you are not getting. क्योंकि 7 का स्क्वायर करती हो तो 49 मिलता है, 8 का स्क्वायर करती हो तो 64 मिलता है, but 55 is lying between them. So 55 is not a perfect square number. Got it? It is a simple natural number. Like 81, you all know is ending with 5, is ending with 1, so it may or may not be a perfect square number. But we all know that it is the square of 9. So it is a perfect square number. So if the number is ending with 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9, it may or may not be a perfect square number. But here it is ending with 1, so it may be a perfect square number. And we are sure that it is 9 square, so it is a perfect square number. 81, which is 9 square is equal to 81. 81 is a perfect square number. Got it? And if it is ending with 1, so it may or may not be a perfect square number, but here it is 9 square, so it is surely be a perfect. Next is 49, which is 7 square. So 49 is again, 49 is a perfect square number. Next is 69. Both are ending with 9. This is a perfect square number because it is 7 square. But the next number is 69, which is not perfect square number because it is not the square of any number. So 69 is ending with 9. So 69 is not a perfect square number. You can write the related property here also. You can write the property also. If a number is ending with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9, they may or may not be a perfect square number. So you can write the property as well. But yeah, I suggest you that always write a related property so that there will not be the deduction of your marks. Got it? So always write the property. So here also, if you want to write the property, you can write. You can write me, you have to write. Got it? So you will write here, if the number is ending with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9, it may or may not be a perfect square number. So 55 here is not a perfect square number. Got it? So you will write the related property. I'm writing here, write related property. Got it? Take screenshot. Wait, Ananya. Page 95, try this number 1. Express 21 square as a sum of two consecutive integers. Okay, this is the same property that we have just discussed before starting the try this, that square of any odd number can be expressed as a sum of consecutive positive. Abhi aapko formula bataya tha, like